You've probably heard of vertical asymptotes, but do you know why they exist or what they actually are? To give you some idea, vertical asymptotes are kind of like fences built along a line running through a certain point on the x-axis on the graph of a function. The graph of a function can get close to the asymptote from either side, but it'll never be able to cross or even touch it at all. Perhaps we could think of it as an electric fence, or, since vertical asymptotes are usually drawn as dotted lines, they're like invisible electric fences. Let's call this line, the vertical asymptote, x equals a, for some real number a. Along the x-axis here, you can see that the graph of the function moves infinitely closer to the vertical asymptote, but the actual value of x will never, ever, ever be equal to a. Even if we zoom in thousands of times, you'll find that the two lines will never actually touch. Because they never touch, you may be imagining that the two lines are somehow parallel. But in order to be parallel, these lines would need to have exactly the same slope. The slope of the asymptote, though, is completely vertical, and the slope of the function is constantly changing. So the lines are definitely not parallel, but instead, just infinitely close together. Another question you may have when you're dealing with asymptotes is how they're different from holes or removable discontinuities. Both are places on the function where the graph is discontinuous, right? Well, let's take a look. Here's a graph with an asymptote at x equals 3, and here's one with a hole at x equals 3. Notice that for the hole, the function approaches a certain y value, 2, as it approaches the undefined x value from both sides. That is, the limit from both sides of the hole is the same. In the function with the vertical asymptote, on the other hand, the function goes to positive infinity as it approaches x equals 3. So the limit doesn't exist as x approaches the vertical asymptote, which makes vertical asymptotes very different from removable discontinuities. So what we know now is that a vertical asymptote is not only a place on the graph where the function is undefined, but also a place where the limit, as x approaches the vertical asymptote, doesn't exist. These facts also tell us that vertical asymptotes are non-differentiable, since differentiability would require both continuity and the existence of a limit. In the same way, vertical asymptotes also cannot be critical points or inflection points, since one of the basic parameters for these points is to exist on the function. Neither critical points nor inflection points ever occur at a discontinuity. Now that we know what vertical asymptotes are and are not, the natural next question is, when do these vertical asymptotes appear? That is, how can we tell that a function will or will not have a vertical asymptote? Most often, we run into vertical asymptotes when dealing with rational functions. Rational functions, remember, are the ones that look like this, with a numerator and denominator. These functions have vertical asymptotes whenever they are undefined, and they are undefined whenever their denominator is equal to 0, because, of course, dividing by 0 can't be done. So if we're given a rational function, how do we actually find any vertical asymptotes that it might have? We can find any vertical asymptotes by setting the denominator equal to 0 and then solving for the variable. In this case, we'd find that x equals 4, so there's a vertical asymptote along the line x equals 4 on the graph. Of course, not all rational functions have vertical asymptotes. There are plenty of rational functions with denominators that are never equal to 0, such as this equation, 1 over x squared plus 4. If we set this denominator equal to 0 and try to solve for x, we get that x is equal to the square root of negative 4, which is not a real number, and therefore, this is not a vertical asymptote. There are tons of examples of rational functions like this, so we can't ever assume that a function has a vertical asymptote just because it's a rational function. We also can't assume that just because a function isn't rational, it doesn't have a vertical asymptote. In fact, there's another type of function that always has a vertical asymptote, and that is the logarithmic function. Looking at the graph of y equals natural log of x, it looks like as x approaches 0 from the right side, y approaches negative infinity. Since logarithms are not defined for numbers that are not positive, there will be a vertical asymptote at 0. Other logarithmic functions, similarly, have vertical asymptotes wherever the input to the function, or the argument, is not positive. So for y equals log base 10 of x plus 6, the vertical asymptote will be at negative 6 because at this point, the input to the function would be log base 10 of 0, which is undefined. On the graph, the curve would never cross the line at x equals negative 6. So if a vertical asymptote is an invisible electric fence, we now know how to discover that fence and understand why it exists. To review, vertical asymptotes are places on the graph of a function where the function is not defined and where the limit as x approaches the asymptote does not exist. We also know that vertical asymptotes exist in both rational and logarithmic functions, and we know how to find them in both. In rational functions, we set the denominator of the function equal to 0 and solve for the variable. And in logarithmic functions, we see where the argument of the function would be equal to 0 and know that the vertical asymptote would be along that line.